Hello everyone, so welcome back to today's webinar. So we will discuss about today the snake families we all know. So it will be a very interesting video. So first we see the classification of a snake. Snake comes under the kingdom Animalia, phylum Chordata, the vertebrates we all know. The subphylum Vertebrata, the class Sauropsida, subclass Lepidosauria, order Squamata, and suborder Serpents, or we call as Ophnidias. So what the common sensation of a snake is all about? They are leprosyphilitic miasm. The feeling of being forsaken or not belonging to the society is the prior to their sensation. They feel let down and betrayed by others. There is a feeling of being unfortunate. They have a dirty, disgusting feeling about them. They might develop a skin discoloration to validate his inner feelings. So they are secretive. You know, they have often have the feeling they have to attack those who are more privileged, and they are less powerful, and they have to attack them from a less privileged position. You know, that's the major sensation it has. Seduction is another important theme of snake. You know, they have a great need to be seen by others and appreciated as the person that they have in a snake. Congestion, they experience a sensation of constriction. They feel constriction by themselves and by society, physically cannot tolerate tight clothing, as they often complain of fullness. So interesting, you know. Now we have the families like Colubridae family, which include Elephegutta, the corn snake we all know, Nectris, the grass snake we all know, the Boidae, the next family, which include boa constriction, and pythons were also included in there. Then the Elephidae family, actually the Colubridae family and Boidae family are non-venomous family, but they doesn't have venom, whereas Elephidae and Vipridae are the venom family, you know. So we have an example of Elephidae, there's Naza and Bongerus. We also have Black Mamba is also included in this, the Elephidae family. Now the Vipridae family, the most common family we all know, of the Lachecis, Crotalus horridus, Crotalus cassavella, we all know. So now the Colubridae family, you know, they are the common members like Silagus gyas or Hydrodynastis gyas, the fast water cobra, we all know. Elephegutta, the corn snake, the rat snake. Lamphoripeltis glatula, California, the California king snake. Lampropeltis triangulatum, the milk snake. And the Nectris, the grass snake, we all know. So the family Boidae, the of boas and pythons. So they have the member like boa constrictor Epididymis, Eunectis notalis, python rigidus, python molurus. So they also have the two orders of the Boidae and the Pythonidae, which were also included in that. Now the Elephidae family, the venom family, we all know. We have the common members like Bungerus celeris, the common trait, Dendroepis polypsis, the black mamba, the Dendroepis viridis, western green mamba, Naja nivea, Cape Corva, the Indian king cobra, we all know. Hydropsis sinopsistus, the sea snake. So then the next family is family Vipridae. The Lachecis muta, the Surucucu snake, is included in that. We have the common members of Crotalus cassavella, Crotalus horridus, Lachecis muta, Vipera apsis, Vipera redi. So now how to differentiate this, you know, families, you know. The Colubridae family, the 2/3 of the snakes are included in this, the non-venomous snake. So they are mimicking, threatening the venomous, you know, they used to mimic and threaten us, pretending, figuring to be dangerous. That's the major code they have, but actually they didn't have that power to be dangerous. Oh, the images of increased flexibility of mouth, you often see the snakes like doing like they're doing the mimicry of being dangerous, but actually they won't. Then the body, the pythons were included. Non-venomous, heavy built, stocky, muscular, ability to constrict and suffocate. Images of swallowing. Slow moving, they are slow moving. The python, they have the heavy body, the heavy built structure, the muscular structure. Now the Lepti family, they are venomous and immovable. Then the Viperidae family are highly mobile. attacked when provoked or when structured in a space. They only attack when they are provoked by someone. The Naja snake, the Dendroapsis snake, they only attack when they will be provoked by someone. Until unless they won't attack. Multiple bites and hold on. They actually used to do multiple bites. There is a major theme of injury, alone, solitary, lonely, alone versus the group. There is a major theme of that. I am alone, you know, this group is harassing me. In the sensation matter, the major theme of the animal kingdom, they will display it all. Now the Viperidae family, it's quite different from the Lepti family. The Naja versus the Lachesis, completely different. The Dendroapsis versus the Crotalus horridus, completely different from each other. They are venomous, highly movable, where they are immobile, the Lepti family. They are well-planned, chlamorophage, you know, they used to, you know, change their color according to the surrounding. They will wait, sudden ambush and attack without warning. They will they can also attack without being provoked. You know, they will attack suddenly and sharply without warning. Where in Naja, you know, they will resist him for some time, but Lachesis won't resist him for some time. He will attack accurately, lightning speed, and leave swiftly, leave no chance to escape. They attack so accurately. They want to be in a group. Where, you know, the Lepti family, you don't want to be in alone. So these are the major differences between the snake family. Hopefully you all have understood this video, the snake family, which I am trying to understand you. So I am to show reverence to all my gurus who taught me so much. You contact to me, Nishant25smilebox@gmail.com, and do subscribe to my channel.